Grace, mercy, and peace be unto you from God our Father, and from our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Would you please pray with us? Father in heaven, we ask you to continue to boldly lead us and direct us, especially for our moms as we offer our thanksgiving and our praise of all the ladies who are moms in our midst. We ask you, Father, to bless them and to strengthen them by your grace and lead them to confidence, knowing that their wonderful gift of momming is built upon your gift of love to us through Christ. We pray this in Jesus' name. And all God's children say,
Amen.
Well, today we're going to focus on our life as now we see God in our actions and in the life that is before us. And moms, I've got a question for you. Are you confident? Confident in what, you may ask? Well, first of all, how about confident in your role as mom? Are you confident in your role as mom? Now, many of us would probably say, yes, I am. I'm very confident. And some of those who say, yes, I am very confident, will probably say, I hope nobody calls me on that. Because sometimes we look at our roles as moms and also as dads. We look at our roles and we go, I don't know. I don't know if I can do this or not. I mean, sometimes my children can be so, what shall we say, overwhelming. Sometimes their energy, they're just playfulness, just playing and going around and just having a wonderful time and energy. And you think to yourself, I can't keep up. Sometimes as moms, we look at our desires and our wants as a parent, and we say, how well am I doing? I don't know. Am I doing well? Well, sometimes how confident are you in your role as mom leads us to ask the similar question, how confident are you in your role as a Christian person? Because they're connected. Your role as mom and your role as a Christian person are linked together. Because sometimes as your faith gets a little weak, maybe sometimes your activity as mom is also weak. Because as we will see from our text, from John's first letter to the church, your role as mom is directly linked to your life as a Christian woman. And your strength that you have, and that grace that you have, and that love that you have, comes some from yourself and your own love and desire for your children, but more, it comes from the love and the grace and the mercy that comes from God. So are you confident in your role as a mom and as a person of Christ through faith? Yes. Through faith in what God has done for you, through faith, your confidence comes from God. I want to draw your attention to our epistle lesson, our letter from John chapter 1. And he says to us, in the realm of our grace, he says, anyone who believes in the Son of God has this testimony in his heart or her heart. Anyone who does not believe God has made him out to be a liar because he has not believed in the testimony God has given about his Son. And this is the testimony. God has given us eternal life, and this life is in his Son. I write these things that you believe in the name of God, the Son of God, so that you know that you have eternal life. And this is a confidence we have approaching God. That if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. Our strength as a mom, and yes, our strength even as dads, our strength even as pastors and leaders of the congregation, does not come to us and through us by our own abilities. No, because our abilities are sinful and centered upon ourselves. A lot of times we'll do things that will make us feel good, more so than we'll lead other people to Christ. or lead other people to the love that is Christ. We are selfish in that regard, but thanks be to God, He gives us Christ Himself so that we have faith and trust in Him. And as believers in Christ, we have this confidence, a confidence that God will hear us. As believers in Christ, we have this joy, knowing that God is with us. As believers in Christ and what Jesus has done for us, we have this strength that comes not from ourselves, but from faith in the promises that God gives to us. Are we confident through faith? Yes. And from where does faith come? Well, faith comes to us through hearing. Paul writes to us in chapter 10 of his Bible, of his letter to the church in Rome. He tells to us, as in the scripture says, anyone who trusts in him will never be put to shame. For there is no difference between Jew and Gentile. The same Lord is Lord of all and richly blesses all who call on him. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. How can they call on the one they have not believed in? And how can they believe in the one of whom they have not heard? And how can they hear without someone preaching to them? And how can they preach unless they are sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news. Faith comes based on hearing, rooted in the Word. Founded and rooted in the Word, the promises that are in our text from John, confidence in the resurrection. Our strength, our love, our support, our grace, everything that we have comes from God. Everything that we are comes from Jesus Christ. And everything that we have as moms and dads, the strength, the courage, the desire, the love comes through Christ to us. And that's where we have our confidence as moms. That's where we have our confidence and our trust. God has given to you, mom, the confidence and the strength to go forward. When sometimes our children are a little, how shall we say, unlovable, crazy, seemingly out of their minds, which child hasn't done that to their mom? Oops, women. No, I did that to my mom. I drove my mom crazy. But I love my mom, and my mom loves me, and we continue to move forward in that regard, and it's a great joy to know that she's always been there for me. And yes, every once in a while, my mom had to say those famous words, wait till your father gets home. Okay, I am in real trouble right about now. But mom, you do a wonderful job, and I appreciate all the moms and all the things that they have done for their children, but mainly the love that they have and continue to share with their children. Whether their children are less than a year old or greater than 60, you still love us no matter what. We really appreciate that. But your faith, the faith and the promise, the strength that you've given to us is rooted in the Word. It is also founded on the promises. Founded on the promises. The promises, again, that God says to us, you are my child. You are the one in whom I love. You are the one for whom I die. And I promise, Jesus said, through that death, I give you forgiveness of sins. Through that death, I cleanse your lives. Yes, you used to be scarlet in your sins and your sinfulness, disobedient, disrespectful. However, I died to forgive you and save you of all of that. Yes, you were sinful. But through grace and the mercy of Jesus Christ, we are no longer scarlet, we are white. Made clean by the blood of Jesus Christ. We have been cleansed through God's love and mercy, and it made manifest in Jesus Christ. We have the Holy Spirit who came to us and gave us life and forgiveness and grace. God has given us all of this. So these are His promises. And based upon those promises, we say, yes. But we don't say it with pompousness, and we don't say it with a hint of arrogance. We say yes with a lot of humility. We say, yes, God. I don't deserve it. Man, I don't deserve it. But you give me life and forgiveness. And because of that, I am eternally grateful. And because of those promises, I will follow through. I will be the best mom, the best dad, the best son, the best daughter. Because of your promises for us, I have that confidence to be that person you made me to be. Finally, faith is based upon hearing and lived through forgiveness. Whenever I counsel a couple who wants to be married, I share with them a lot of things. I share with them the foundations of what it is to be a Christian household, to be one in Christ, what that means. I also share with them many of the things that they have identified, and we deal with the challenges and the like. But one of the key elements that I share with the couples, that I said, there are no three better words that you can say to your husband, no three better words that you can say to your wife. And those three words are, please forgive me. No better words you can say that in the realm of any relationship. A child to a parent, a husband to a wife, a wife to her husband. Please forgive me. I was a total and complete jerk. Please forgive me. I was selfish and self-centered, and I ran my mouth off when I shouldn't. Please forgive me. Please forgive me for my lack of confidence as being a parent. And God, in His wonderful grace and His love for us, infinite, unbounded, unfettered, says, yes, I forgive you. I've given you that forgiveness by what my Son did on your behalf. He walked that perfect life. Do you realize that there was only a single man throughout all the history of mankind, one single man that could ever and always obey the will of God? And He's not just a man. He is both 100% man and 100% God. There is only one, His name is Jesus, that could perfectly obey the will of God. Only one. And He did that because He knew you could not. And He came upon this earth to fulfill all the righteous regulations that God desires for us, as well as to be the sacrifice for those sins. To be the sacrifice for our sins and our sinfulness, so that when Jesus died on the cross, we say to God, I'm sorry, please forgive me. Please forgive me. And at the same time, I ask you, God, for the power and the strength to follow and to do as you command, not because I must, but because I want to. I want to be the best mom I can be. I want to be the best dad I can be, because I am responding to your great love and mercy for me. I have confidence. I can do this. I can do this because God loves me. faith in the promises that is God in Christ Jesus. I have faith in Christ and what he did for me. And I trust him. I trust him to give me the power and the strength that is Christ to do what God calls me to do as a mom and also as a dad and a follower of Jesus. So moms, here's my wonderful recommendation. Well, I don't know wonderful. Be confident. Be confident in being a mom. Sometimes your children will challenge you in that confidence. Sometimes it will be not as strong as it could be. But be confident not in your own self, but be confident in the promises that is God. And know this, that whatever you ask for from God, because you have confidence and faith in him, he will answer and give you what you need. Happy Mother's Day, moms. In Jesus' name.